Hello all, welcome to Developing Success, and we are talking about UPSC Civil Service syllabus pattern and eligibility in this lecture, in this video. And this will be very helpful for the beginners especially, because I have totally discussed in length about the pattern, about the syllabus and the eligibility. Let me tell you that in this lecture we will be covering the pattern, and for the syllabus and eligibility you will have to see a separate video, because this is a big topic. So before starting your UPSC preparation, the pattern, the syllabus and the eligibility conditions should be very clearly mentioned and should be very clear in your mind, so that no mistake should be done in the beginning of the preparation. So the UPSC civil services exams, as you know, you get the services like IAS, you get the services like IPS, Indian Police Service, you also get the services like Indian Revenue Service, also Indian Foreign Service, IFS. So let me tell you that these services are actually definable in very length. So you need to know what these services are all about, what do we do when we get the job. So for this we do the workshop and seminar in our institute. You can attend this seminar and workshop free of cost. And for this information, when this seminar will be held, you can check the website developingsuccess.org, or you can visit our Facebook page, or you can also call and WhatsApp on these numbers. Okay, so you can always do that. But for this lecture, I will be explaining you the much important topic, that is the pattern of the exam. So the pattern of the exam says that UPSC is taken in three stages. So the three stages are: the first stage is actually your preliminary exam, that is the prelims exam. The second stage is mains exam, and the third stage is personality test. Let me tell you, the whole process, prelims to the interview, it takes 1 year for the whole process to get complete. Okay, in the prelims section you will see that it will be held between May to June, and in the mains examination it will be held around October or September end, and the personality test around January end, and Feb till March also it can go. So this is the thing. Now I will tell you about the pattern of prelims, mains and interview. So if I talk about the prelims section, the prelims section is a qualifying exam. Why is it a qualifying exam? Because the marks which you score in the prelims examination is not added in the final total of your score. Okay, it is not added. So it is just a qualifying exam before your mains exam. Okay, so the prelims exam, when you clear, you are called for the mains exam, and when you clear the mains exam, you are again called for the interview. So the marks of interview plus your mains exam, the interview and the mains exam will be counted as your final score. So if in the prelims exam if you score 100 or if you score the full marks, that doesn't matter, you just need to clear the examination. Okay, so this is just a qualifying exam. Now I will talk in length about the prelims. So in the prelims exam you have two papers, as you can see here I have written, and both the papers are MCQ type. What do you mean by MCQ? That they will be giving you a question, and the options will be A, B, C, D, and you have to choose one of the options which you find is the correct one. This is what you mean by the MCQ type of exam. Now there are two papers in prelims exam: GS paper 1, which is known as general studies paper 1, and GS paper 2. So the GS paper 1 is actually the main paper, and this paper decides the cutoff marks, or this paper decides that you are clearing it or you are not clearing. Okay, but this paper, the CSAT, Civil Services Aptitude Test, this was introduced in 2011, but now it has just remained as a qualifying paper in the UPSC prelims exam. So in this qualifying nature, what does it say? If you qualify, so this paper is actually of 200 marks and you need to score 67 minimum. If you score this, then only your prelims paper will be checked, otherwise it will not be checked. Okay, so you got that. Now I will tell you about the marks. So in the general studies paper 1, you are asked 100 questions, Every question is of 2 marks, that accounts to 200 marks. In the CSAT paper, you are asked 80 questions. Every question is around 2.5 marks, that accounts to again 200 marks. So the total is 400, but the main paper is this one, and this one is just the qualifying paper. So in this, you need to score just the 67 marks. Now, I want to tell you about the negative marking. So in the negative marking thing, you will be having 1/3 negative marking for both the papers, okay? For both the papers, you will be having 1/3 negative marking. What does that mean? How is it calculated? So there are 100 questions in total. I am talking about GS paper 1. And in those 100 questions, you attempted 80 questions, okay? So in this 80 question, you are attempting 80 questions, and in 80 questions, 21 suppose are your wrong answers, and the remaining 59 are your correct answers. Okay, so how will you calculate? I told you that it is 1/3. So 1/3 means for every 3 wrong answers, listen to it very carefully, that every 3 wrong answers, 1 correct answer will be cancelled. Okay, so for every 3 wrong answer, 1 correct answer will be cancelled. So 21, we will be dividing it by 3, that will amount to 7. So the correct answer is 59, and 59, we will be cancelling 7 answers, so that remains with 52. So 52 is your net correct score. So one question will be of 2 marks, so 52 into 2 will be 110. Okay, sorry, 52, 104. So this will be your final score. Okay, so this is how you calculate. So there is 1/3 negative marking for both the papers. I am telling it again and again, for both the papers. So this is about the prelims exam. Next we come to the mains exam. In the mains exam, you have two sections. One is qualifying and the other one is the main papers. Okay, so these qualifying papers, these are only of qualifying nature, and so the marks will not be added in the final exam. Okay, in the final total list, the marks will not be added. But there is a very important thing to note, that if you don't qualify in these two papers, your main papers will not be checked. Okay, so first they will check these two papers, and if you pass in these two papers, then only the main papers will be checked, otherwise it will not be checked. So the qualifying papers are two. The first paper is paper A, and this paper A is of Indian languages. So you can choose one of the Indian languages present in the 8th schedule of the constitution, and it has 22 Indian languages. So in that 22, you can choose one, like Hindi or your Bodo, your Bengali, Assami, all that. In paper 3, you will be have to attempt English as your paper. Okay, so 300 marks, you need to score only 30%. And in 300 marks English, you need to score only 25%. Okay, 30% of 300 marks and 25% of 300 marks. If you get this, then the further papers will be checked. Okay, so this has been mentioned by the UPSC. So further papers, what are the further papers? These are the main papers which are given for the selection. So the first paper is paper 1, which is known as essay paper, and it amounts to 250 marks. Let me tell you, there will be 2 essays asked, and each essay will be containing 125 marks, that accounts to 250 marks. So there will be 2 groups. There will be one group as group A, and there will be another as group B. So each group will be having 4 choices. In this 4, you will be answering just one essay. So one each, 125 marks, that accounts to 250 marks. Next is your paper 2, which is known as general studies paper 1, and this accounts to 250 marks again, and it will be having syllabus like culture, history, geography. Syllabus I will explain you in another video in very detail, very nicely. The next paper, paper 3, will be general studies paper 2, governance and polity, 250 marks again. General studies paper 3, technology, science, environment, disaster management, 250 marks again. General studies paper 4, ethics, integrity and aptitude, 250 marks again. So let me tell you, this GS paper 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 GS papers plus 1 SA paper. Okay. So 5 papers I have explained you. The 6th paper will be your optional paper and the 7th paper will be also optional paper. For example, you choose the optional geography. Okay. So there will be geography paper 1 and geography paper 2. There are no separate papers. There is just one subject which is having two papers, 250 marks each. So there are 7 papers in total. The total is 1750. For each paper, you will be having 3 hours of time. And for each paper, you will be having 20 questions. And this paper is not MCQ. It is descriptive type. Let me tell you, it is descriptive type. So I think you understood. I will just brief you once again that the essay paper is 250 marks. Then you have paper GS paper 1, GS paper 2, GS paper 3 and GS paper 4, each 250 marks. And you have to choose one optional subject which will be having two papers. One subject, two papers, 250 marks each, that accounts to 500 and the total will be 1750. So your score for mains will be 1750. Okay. So the score which you will be attaining will be from 1750 marks. Now, these optional subjects, when you choose, you need to choose the optional subjects from these given 25 subjects. Like, and also these literature you can choose. So any of them you can choose. You can choose agriculture, you can choose Kannada, you can choose geography or Manipuri or Assamese, Bengali, management, philosophy. So this is the list from where you can actually choose. So 25 plus 23, okay? These many subjects and literature they have given, you have to choose just one. So you have just one optional paper, okay? So now I come up. So from here we know that mains examination, there will be 1750 marks paper altogether, 7 paper in number, okay? And in this 1750 marks, what you score will be your final score for the mains examination. The next stage is your interview stage, and in this interview stage there will be a personality test which will be having 275 marks. So in that 275 marks, what you score, they will be adding this and this, and your final score will be here. Okay, so your final score will be from 1750 plus 275, that accounts to 2025. So 2025 is your total marks and this will be your final score. Okay, so the interview is not a group discussion like SSB CDA ND CDS and ND exams, but it will be a individual interview, personality test interview. There will be a group of members, 4-5 members, and you will be the only person there. And they will be asking you some questions regarding your hobbies, regarding the international affairs, regarding the current events, regarding some other questions also. So this is the whole pattern of the examination. Let's sum up the lecture once so that it is easy for you. So the first stage is your prelims exam. In the prelims exam, you have two paper, GS paper 1 and CSAT paper. So this is qualifying and you need to score only 67 marks out of 200. And out of 200, this is the main paper which will clear, which will make you clear. So when you clear, you are called for the mains examination. In mains examination, there are again two qualifying papers, that is paper A and B. Paper A is the language paper, any language you can choose from the 22 languages mentioned in the schedule. And paper B will be your English. So if you clear this paper, like in the language paper, you need to score 30% marks of 300. And in English paper, you need to score 25% marks of 300. If you clear this, then only your further papers will be checked. The further papers of the mains are essay paper, that is also 250 marks. Then you have GS paper 1, paper 2, paper 3 and paper 4, each accounting to 250 marks. Okay. And then you need to choose one optional subject. An optional subject will be having two papers, 250 marks each again. That accounts to 1750 marks, as you can see. Okay. So this 1750 marks will be of your mains exam. This will be your main paper. And when you clear this exam, then what you score in 1750 marks, then you will be called for interview. Interview will be 275 marks, total will be 2025 marks, and this will be your score. So this was about the pattern of the examination, and you should watch another video of mine, which is on the syllabus. Okay, so syllabus and eligibility, understand the pattern well, and then we can come up for the syllabus. Okay, thank you.